Informatics, and today she will be talking to us about what biotechnology is and how it helps humans. It's helping humanity today to solve a large number of problems. So, friends, one thing we would like to know is, are there people here who do not understand Hindi? So if you do not understand Hindi, so please write in the chat box, then we will largely stick to English. But if everyone understands Hindi, then we can keep it bilingual, because there are people with different kinds of comforts with language. So so if you can understand, then please don't write. But if you don't understand, then please write. Then we will not use Hindi. We will accordingly request Professor Mishra to accordingly talk. She can comfortably talk in both languages. So we are just trying to see what is the best for the audience. So so friends, will you, anybody who does not understand Hindi, only those people respond who are sure that they do not understand Hindi. So if you will just let us know, it will be great. So one person has said he doesn't understand Hindi. Are there more people? Are there more people who do not understand Hindi? Okay. So Dr. Mishra, Krishna ji, it seems there are some people who don't understand Hindi at all. So I would request you to please largely keep it in English. Friends, from the audience, there is a request that if you have any questions, please write it in the chat box. In the chat box, you can write in Hindi if you do not understand, or if you cannot speak in English or write in English well. So your questions during the talk should be written on the chat box. Everyone is requested to keep their mic on mute, so there is no disturbance coming from their side. After the first 45 minutes of the talk, we will then present the questions, summary of the questions to Professor Mishra, and then she will answer them. So that will be an interactive part. Currently, she will be speaking. So with that, I'm very happy once again to, from the side of Joy of Learning Foundation, from the side of Sri Aurobindo Society Pondicherry, we are very happy to bring to you this talk, which is sponsored by NCSTC, National Council for Science and Technology Communication, which is a part of Department of Science and Technology. So over to you, Krishna ji. We are eagerly waiting for your lecture. Krishna ji, we can't hear you. You are probably on mute. Krishna ji, you are on mute.
Yeah.
Now we can hear you. And please, can you make your camera a little lower? We can see only half your face. So just a little lower so that your full face is visible. Yes, this is so much better.
Yes. Okay now?
Yes, absolutely. Great.
Okay, thank you. Thank you. So, good morning, everyone. Now, at the very onset, I would like to thank the organizers for giving me this opportunity to talk to you about biotechnology. I think now biotechnology has become everyone knows about the name biotechnology, but exactly what it is and how it is helping the mankind, that I would like to express in as much simple words as possible, because there are many people who are lay persons here, and specifically I'm talking to the students, especially who are very anxious to take up their career later on. So I would like to emphasize, you know, as the name suggests, biotechnology. You know, bio is right from a cell to any microorganism, bacteria, viruses, fungi, yeasts, any animal cell, any plant cell, any plant, any animal, and including human being. So anything which is living, that is any technique which uses a living thing to produce a useful product. Useful, it may be a product, it may be a concept, it may be a good technique, whatever it is. So using the living thing for producing something which is useful for mankind, you can say, comes under biotechnology. It has a very wide umbrella. Bahut bada umbrella iske niche biotechnology ke paas hai, which includes genetic engineering. Genetic engineering, I will just like to explain here, gene, because, you know, in common talk, people say that, what is gene? That the offsprings, the children, they inherit the properties of parents through genes. So what is gene? Which transfers the properties, characteristics from parents to offsprings. It may be in human, it may be in animal, it may be any microorganism, it may be a plant, any living thing. So gene actually are small parts of a big molecule known as DNA. DNA is deoxynucleic acid, a chemical molecule which is present in every living cell. So these small sequences, because that, you know, you can say that it is a long molecule, it may be a few kilometers long, folded, lying inside the cell, you know, inside the nucleus. So there are, you know, you can say that this is made up of four bases are there, and these sequence of these letters is important. Certain segments, certain pieces from this molecule, they carry certain characteristics which are carried to the offsprings from parents. So this is important, and this comes under the study of genetic engineering, how you engineer the genes. So it may be in plants, it may be in animals. So, you know, the oldest technique in biotechnology is not a new subject. It has come now, the importance has been realized now, but it is a very old subject. You know, converting milk into curd, that is fermentation. And in everyday life also, you take many fermented products. You know, this fermentation, this was discovered long back by a scientist by name of Louis Pasteur. And you know that even now we use the word pasteurized milk. So fermentation technology is very well known for very long time. So it is not a new subject. But now in modern biotechnology, many things have come which are very important for human being, for welfare of man. And this is what I'm trying to explain today. So many subjects, you know, it is a multidisciplinary subject, and many disciplines, like maybe at molecular level, any of the basic science, like molecular chemistry, molecular physics, molecular biology, you can say microbiology, genetics, any subject. When you study at molecular level, you can say that comes under biotechnology. So what is the aim of this subject, biotechnology? You know that DNA was discovered in 1954 by three scientists who got Nobel Prize for that. And that was the beginning of new, or you can say modern, biotechnology. Because if the structure was DNA or was not known, all those things, marvelous things which have happened, could not have happened. So that is, you know, that started with the discovery of the helical structure of DNA. Now, I think, children, you must have seen at many places the helical-like structure of DNA. And that was for the first time discovered by Watson and Crick. Now, DNA that molecule is being now used in various ways for manipulating genes, manipulating the characteristics in any living matter, and that is genetic engineering. So use of biotechnology is great now in fields of agriculture and medicine, because you know that these two are extremely important for the country. Agriculture, because population is increasing, the size of land is the same, or I would say that more agricultural land is being used for construction and other things for industry. So this is a very big problem, not only for India, but at global level also. So what to do? Now here biotechnology comes in use, because whatever crops you grow, you can improve the quality, the quantity of the crop by using this technique of genetic engineering. Now, biotechnology is also being used now greatly in the field of medicine. You know, you can produce new drugs, you can design drugs. I'll come to this point a little later. Now, let us see that how many types of biotechnology, you can call it bioeconomy, because economy of any country can be improved if we take to biotechnological processes. I'm trying to explain that in as many simple words as possible. You know, one thing is that bioinformatics, all of you know informatics. Now, bioinformatics, you can call it computational biology. That means you are using computers for solving the biological problems. So this, if you have the concept of biology, as I say, at molecular level, and then apply computer for solving those problems, make algorithms, then it is bioinformatics. So bioinformatics is a very important part of biotechnology. Without that, you cannot do, because the reason is that now the data which is coming out of research is so big. Itna bada data aa raha hai, usko kaise karenge? Humanly, it is not possible to analyze the data. So need of computer is there. You know, when human mind cannot manage so much bulk of data, we need computers. Now, there are disciplines coming like functional genomics. Now, gene is okay. When we study genes of the whole living system, the structure of these molecules and how they function. So the study of function becomes functional genomics, and study of structure becomes structural genomics. Similarly, proteins, because you know these two biomolecules, DNA, RNA, which are nucleic acids, and proteins. Proteins may be enzymes or receptors. Dono ho sakte hain. Enzymes to aapko pata hai, aap science mein padhte ho, that it can increase the rate or modulate the rate of any reaction. So biological molecules, proteins, which act as catalysts, they are enzymes. So the study of this on the whole is proteomics. Now, biotechnology has been classified as blue biotechnology, green biotechnology, red biotechnology, and white biotechnology. Now, as the name suggests, blue biotechnology, blue is immediately ocean comes to mind. So anything which is marine, you know, ocean is a big treasure of animals, plants, everything which has not been studied exhaustively so far. Abhi ocean par bahut study nahi hua. So marine aquatic applications, अभी बहुत ज़्यादा इसमें रिसर्च की ज़रूरत है. बायोटेक्नोलॉजी कैन सॉल्व सो मेनी प्रॉब्लम्स इफ द एनिमल्स एंड प्लांट्स, मेरीन एनिमल्स एंड प्लांट्स, दोज हैव टू बी स्टडीड. देन ग्रीन, एज द नेम सजेस्ट्स, इज एग्रीकल्चर. सो बायोटेक्नोलॉजी अप्लाइड टू एग्रीकल्चरल प्रोसेसेस. Here, you know, earlier there was to improve the plants, to increase the yield of plants, they used to use the traditional breeding methods, because whichever plant gave better product, that was crossed with another one, so that the plant which comes out, that has the properties of both the trees. So that was, you know, how traditional breeding was done. Micropropagation, you know, about tissue culture, because you can take any living cell or any part of a tissue and you can give artificial food, which is known as media, in the lab, and grow these plants in the lab under ideal conditions, so that the small plants which grow, they have all the good qualities. That means they can give better yields, they can give more quantitative yields. So from tissue culture, after growing it to some extent, they take it to fields. Wo khet mein laga dete hain, and then the plants grow. Now transgenic plants are coming. As I said, that gene which has the property, specific properties, you take from one material and you transfer it to another. So plants, transgenic plants now are becoming very, very important. Red biotechnology means applied to medical processes. So here, you know, the development of drugs used to take lot of time. You know, one drug development, developing one new drug means, you know, 4 or 5 years at least. But now the time has been reduced. And then manufacturing drugs, you know, some drugs have got complicated structures. So it used to take lot of time, steps, cost, energy, sab lagta tha to make a complicated molecule. Many antibiotics are now produced by bacteria. Bacteria are being used for making certain drugs or antibiotics. Now, many diseases which are caused by faulty genes, जीन में कहीं गड़बड़ हो जाता है, सो दे आर मैनिपुलेटेड, उसको जीन थेरेपी बोलते हैं, जीन से उसको ट्रीट कर दिया. वाइट बायोटेक्नोलॉजी इज अ बायोटेक्नोलॉजी अप्लाइड टू इंडस्ट्रियल प्रोसेसेस. इंडस्ट्री में बायो दिस बायो कैटलिस्ट, दिस एंजाइम्स आर बीइंग नाउ यूज्ड फॉर मेकिंग वेरी बेनिफिशियल प्रोडक्ट्स, दैट इज इंडस्ट्रियल बायोटेक्नोलॉजी. Now coming to one by one to green biotechnology first. Green biotechnology can help in two special ways. Two issues are there. One is, as I said, increasing the yield and bettering the yield in plants, genetically modified foods. Because now is the time is coming when population is so much and the size of land is same, so we have to see that the quality, the crops which are growing, they should yield more and better products. So for that matter, genetic engineering is used in plants. Another problem is energy, because we know that fuels are being exhausted like anything, and we have to have alternative sources. I feel happy when I hear that so many alternative sources are being, the car is being, you know, driven by air or water or whatever. But I think these alternative biofuels can be produced with the help of biotechnology. Now I'm coming to the part which is genetic engineering. As I said, that genes, those specific parts, segments of DNA, how they can make the quality of plants and animals better. These are some examples where the quality has been improved. like tomato. You know, tomato earlier could not be grown on hills, and now tomato is being grown in any frosty conditions also. Now there are many crops which were affected badly by attacking insects or other pathogens. Lekin abhi the genetically modified products, they are not harmed by any attacking insects. So that is the advantage that has come. You can see many, some of these have been shown here, but there are many others which are being produced by genetic modification. Now I'm giving you for your interest some examples, because you know gene is genetic code is universal. Now what is the meaning? That DNA can produce RNA, RNA will give rise to protein, and proteins are enzymes, as I said. So in any living system, all the time chemical reactions are going on, and these chemical reactions are helped by enzymes. That means that this is how DNA forms RNA, RNA forms proteins. So this is genetic code, and genetic code is same universal, means same in plants, same in bacteria, same in viruses, same in man, same in animals, no difference. So in such an example, these examples are very interesting. There is a chemical alpha 1 antitrypsin which is formed in human, and that is a substance which is helpful in curing lung diseases. Now this gene in human which produces this molecule is put into sheep. Now that sheep, whatever they collect milk from the sheep, and from that milk they isolate this drug. So it becomes easy. Then, you know, there was a disease which was caused by rota virus. Now we are all troubled with COVID-19. Viruses, they cause different diseases. So this rota virus caused diarrhea in, especially in children, specifically in African countries and Asian countries, and there was a lot of problem. So now as we are talking about vaccine for COVID-19, instead of vaccine, you know, what was done? That a gene was put in rice, because most people are rice eating people. You know? So this specific gene was put into rice, and whosoever ate that rice got the antibody. Now see how easy it becomes. Just by eating rice, you are getting your immunity to fight for a virus. I hope the same thing happens for COVID-19 also. Now, chicken. Many of you may be non-vegetarian eating chickens. And you know the first thing when the whole chicken comes in a dish, the first thing you pick up is the leg. That is supposed to be most delicious. So they thought that why not put some genes in chicken? That instead of two legs, it has four legs and no wings, because wings are of no use. So, you know, I was talking about tomato growing on hills. How did they do it? They found that in countries, very cold countries like Siberia, where whole year there is ice. Now, fish, how do fish survive under so many feet of ice? So they took out that fish which survived under snow and found out the gene. Now that means that gene is responsible for keeping it alive under frosty conditions. So they put that gene into many other vegetables, including tomato. Now all those can be grown in any cold condition, any frosty condition. So just imagine, I mean, this is really extremely good. Then creating a goat with spider genes that creates silk. You know, spider makri jo jaal banati hai, you know the strength of the thread of that spider web. That is wonderful. Now, they put the spider genes into the goat, and the goat milk, from goat milk, they can manufacture silk. Now, genetically modified rice, as I said, they can deliver antibodies. Cholera vaccine, instead of cholera vaccine, they put the antibody into potatoes. Pigs bearing spinach genes, strawberry having frost fresh genes. So isn't it all very, very interesting and very challenging? So as I have already said, there is only one language of life. So you can put human genes in bacteria, monkey genes in mice, and anything, tree genes in bananas, frog genes work in rice. There is no limit to theory of this genetic engineering. So it has given the man a power to alter the very basis of life on earth. Here is one example of this maize, you know, bhutta, everything everyone knows, that used to be attacked by corn borer. Not so much in our country, but in some other countries, it was a very big problem. And now they have genetically modified maize. They have put BT protein. You know, BT is a bacteria, Bacillus thuringiensis. The first BT project was cotton. And now they have put this gene from bacteria in many vegetables, including corn, many other vegetables now. They contain bangan may be dala hai, and many other countries. So now they have, this is a toxin producing gene, and they isolate it from bacteria. Bacteria se unhone ye nikala, aur ye bacteria soil mein paya jata hai. It is found in soil. So they took out that DNA from this bacteria, cut the gene, and put it into maize. Brinjal is another, cotton is another, tomato, everything, you know, and so many vegetables. They have put this. So now no pathogen, no insect affects that crop. So when the insects come, they are killed. So this is the advantage. Now you can see here on the left is your genetically engineered beans, and on the right, the normal ones. Krishnaji, so you can see that attack.
Krishnaji, you'll have to tell us the slide number. We'll show it to the audience.
I have to tell you, okay?
Yeah, because they are not constantly seeing the slides.
It is not visible?
No, you'll have to tell us. Whenever you say, if you say, we will run the full slideshow.
Okay, then I will say that you change the slide. Huh? Okay, will that be okay?
Yeah. So you tell us the slide number, we'll open it, and you ask us to change it, and we'll do it.
Okay, so present is slide number 17.
Hmm? Okay.
So we are going to slide number 18 now.
Okay, we are just opening that slide.
Is it okay? Slide number 18.
We are on 18.
Yes. Natural gene transfer.
So yeah, please carry on. So please carry on. You just carry on and just tell us what you want us to show, and we'll show.
Okay, is it okay?
Yes, we are seeing, so you just explain.
Okay, so in this slide, it is shown that how a gene is transferred from bacteria to plant. You know, the specific, as I said, the segment from DNA that is cut, and that is directly injected into the plant cell so that the property connected with this gene is transferred to the plant cell. Right? Next slide, number 19. We can skip this slide, come to the next, number 20. Number 20 slide, you can see the field in African city with the GM rice, which I told you has the antibody to fight rotaviral diarrhea. So just, into this rice, they have put the antibody for that specific virus. Next one is, number 21, slide 21. Now, regarding industrial biotechnology, in biotechnology has been applied to industrial processes in a very big way. I have already said that the bio molecules, the proteins, which are enzymes, they are being used for creating industrially useful products. It may be an antibiotic, it may be any chemical, it may be food, feed, detergents, paper, pulp, textiles, biofuels, anything. And these processes, these bioprocesses, they are really energy efficient. That means energy is being saved, which was otherwise used. Then a lot of raw material, because chemical synthesis used to take so many raw materials, that is decreased. Now there are less poisonous gas emissions. Production costs have become low. So all these advantages industry has got. Next slide, 22. 22, as you can see, so many fermented products, they are available in the market. And every day we use, we eat in the houses. So you can see that how this fermentation process has been successfully used for producing industrial products. Next one, that is 23, slide 23. You can see here the biodiesel. You know, the most important alternative energy source which has been produced from different sources, including plants also, this is biodiesel. And biodiesel is being produced. The next slide 24, shows plant biofuels as alternative sources. You know, so many plants, you must have heard about Jatropha plant. Jatropha is a wild plant from which this biodiesel was extracted. But however, this is not very commercially viable because of certain reasons. It was not very successful, but now algae is becoming very important alternative for getting biodiesel. Biodiesel is also obtained from any oil. It may be animal fat, vegetable oil, soya oil, rapeseed, mahua oil, mustard oil, flax oil, sunflower, palm oil, hemp, any of these, you know, including algae. Now these are being used for producing biodiesel. So we know that plants use sunlight for making not only chlorophyll, but many other products also. So this technique of the plants, how plants catch solar energy and they produce plants, now this is being exploited. Isko use kar rahe hain so that the plants will produce more products which can give higher yield of these fuels, diesel. So this is how biotechnology is now being used for alternative sources of energy. Well, the next one, 25. This, now we are coming to uses of biotechnology in medical biotechnology. Next one shows that how biotechnology, for example, drug discovery or production, जिसको कि हम biopharmaceutics बोलते हैं, that is a discipline in which drug discovery is told. One of the very important example is of insulin, because many people are diabetic, they take marketed insulin. Before 1978, it used to, all the insulin used to come from animals, mainly pigs. But in 1978, a company known as Genentech, they developed humanized insulin by taking the gene. देखिए एक जीन ही बनाता है ना ह्यूमन में इंसुलिन. उन्होंने they took that gene and वो bacteria में डाल दिया, E. coli. Now bacteria, you know that its population increases like anything. In 1 hour it becomes double. So the production increased, you know, and it is easier to take that liquor and isolate insulin. So now human insulin is available. Another point which I want to especially my students and young students to know, that many times, you know, when you take any drug like antibiotic or any other drug, sometimes there is allergy ya koi aur reaction ho jata hai. Why? Sometimes the drug affects, it cures your disease, but sometimes there is no effect and sometimes there is some ill effect. What is the reason? The reason is that every man is man or woman, the person is different genetically, because no two people look alike, they are all different. So why should the same medicine work on everyone? It will not. So now they are realizing that there should be personalized medicine. Every person, according to their genomic structure, must be given the corresponding drug. So this era now, in future, if you go to a doctor, he will first ask you, you know, like your identity card, you will carry a genomic card, and the doctor will prescribe the drug according to your genomic structure. So and now testing also is becoming, you know, very fast. Just a small chip of 1 centimeter square chip can carry 40,000-50,000 DNA sequences. Just imagine, put one drop of blood on that and you can test, you know, in no time. So this is becoming you know, there are 99.9% of your genes are common. You know, you just imagine a human carries genes, 90% genes of bacteria, only 10% genes are human. You know, it's very interesting to know. And 99.9% of your genes, they match with another person, but it is only 0.1% of genes where the variation is there. And that is the variation which drug companies are looking for, making personalized medicines. So many, many things which are known about genes, they are now being analyzed. Next slide is, this number is 28 slide. You know, it is easy to find the structure of the gene, but how it functions, that is difficult to know, the functioning of genes. Next slide, 29 shows, you know, this is a very serious disease, sickle cell anemia, where your red blood corpuscles and blood, they become sickle shaped. And why this happens? Just imagine that in your DNA sequence, only one base A is swapped by T. एक ही जगह किसी तरह से सम मिस्टेक हैपेंस एंड अनदर बेस कम्स, जस्ट वन मिस्टेक बाय डिफॉल्ट इन नेचर गिव्स यू सच ए सीरियस डिजीज. सो दिस इज व्हाई वेयर जीन थेरेपी, नेक्स्ट स्लाइड 30 इज जीन थेरेपी. सो इट वॉज नीडेड दैट यू should change somehow the gene part. If you can displace the gene with another normal one, that will cure the disease. Kyunki jahan par galti hua hai, wherever the mistake has taken place, that particular sequence has to be changed. Now the problem was what they did, like isolated, they extracted the gene, functioning gene. Suppose in a human being some gene is not working, insulin ka gene hai, that is not producing insulin at all, so you get diabetic. Now what they do, they take the gene responsible for insulin and then they insert directly into your cell. Wo nucleus mein directly dal dega. So this technique is now being used by doctors. The next one, 31, this is you must have all now heard the news that Nobel Prize of this year 2020 has gone to two women scientists, and they have for what? For genetic engineering, for editing the genome. So genome engineering, they got Nobel Prize, and this is what I wanted to emphasize, that now time has come when gene manipulation can take place for any treatment of any complex disease, which may be cancer, heart disease, mental, human immunodeficiency, HIV, or any this thing. And I hope that soon they will find for this COVID also some gene editing. Next one, this, I'm not going into details of the mechanism, how gene editing takes place, but I can tell you that viruses, like they are attacking human, they also attack microorganisms, they attack bacteria also. You know, that is one reason why Ganga water, you keep it for years together, it doesn't go bad. Why? What is the reason? Why Ganga Jal doesn't get any toxic thing in it? You can keep it for years together, because there are such viruses. If any bacteria comes in the river, immediately those viruses, they attack, form bacteriophages. So this mechanism is working here also for gene editing, because the bacteria, they are developing immunity for viruses. So this is very interesting to know, but somehow I'm going to the next one. Next one, I want to emphasize here that earlier, they used to synthesize at least hundreds of compounds, go on testing them in laboratories, in vitro testing, matlab cells mein, living cells per test karte the, animals per test karte the. And then somehow in a period of 4 to 6, 7 years, somehow, some used to take 2 to 3 years, some used to take 4, 5 years, some used to take more than that. So much time was taken for discovery of one drug. But now drugs are becoming resistant. Penicillin was used for 50 years, but now penicillin has no effect, because the pathogen, jo organism hai, which it used to kill, they have also become very clever. They have changed their metabolism and they make the drug ineffective. So resistant ho gayi drugs. So now we cannot afford to waste so much of time for developing one drug. Now we are using in silico methods. That means computer comes in. And computer methods are being used for designing drugs and making them. That is a big discovery. Now, next one is 34 slide. Yeah, I think I have already said we can skip that, come to 35. Now, bioinformatics has come in a big way. Genomics, proteomics, combinatorics, anything. You can have one slab on which you can have, say, 196 wells. These plates are available, and each well can have a different reagent. And that's how at one time you can do 96 tests, maybe bigger than that, maybe lesser than that, whatever. But I want to say that hundreds of tests can be done in seconds. So that is the magic of bioinformatics. Role of bioinformatics is mainly to store data, something like an automated environment. So bioinformatics now has come in a big way. Next one is 36 slide. This is report. This was a report in September 2019 that a team of researchers, they successfully used artificial intelligence, means computer methods, to design, synthesize, validate a novel drug candidate in just 46 days. Just imagine, compared to the typical 2-3 years required. Pehle jo 3-4 saal mein banta tha, that was designed and made in 46 days. That was the one wonder of using artificial intelligence. Now, next slide can be slipped. Come to 38. Now, in this you can see the pictorial presentation. Aap picture dekh sakte hain. Left mein, there are 9 patients suffering from colon cancer. The same drug, the same capsule is given. So maybe some of them, they are cured. Some of them have no effect, and some of them have adverse effects. Now on the right, they are properly tested and their genomic structures known. Then different, 3 different drugs are given. They are classified into 3 groups. Different drugs are given. So one group, instead of this thing, all the whole group now recovers. So that is what is the meaning of personalized medicine. Next one is 39. Here I would like to emphasize the dose, because when you go to a doctor, some drug they say take 2 tablets per day, some they say every 4 hourly, some they say every hourly, or only 1 tablet per day. What is this? Why this dose differs? This also depends on the person concerned. Some respond to normal doses, some respond to lower doses, some respond to higher doses, and some they have to be given alternative medicine. So every person, as I said, is genetically different, and different doses also are needed. Now the next is 40. Slide 40 is, you know, this pharma informatics, informatics in drug designing, this is has a very good future, because you know, you can understand that some, suppose 10 patients go to a doctor for treatment for high blood pressure. So he gives medicine to first patient, some medicine, second patient another medicine, third patient another medicine, not the same medicine for one disease. That is what I wish to emphasize here. Next slide is 41. This, in short, I wanted to tell that biotechnology is now also becoming important in purification of water. You know, drinking water is a big problem now, and pollution, you know, bioremediation processes, pollution is sometimes, you know, many toxic substances, they go inside the ground. और फिर जो जमीन से पानी निकलता है वो भी सब पोल्यूटेड होता है. सो फॉर दैट मैटर, यू नो, मेनी केमिकल्स हैव नाउ, दिस टेक्निक हैज नाउ बीन डेवलप्ड. दे पुट आयरन नैनो पार्टिकल्स अलोंग विद सम अदर, मिक्स्ड विद इधर पैलेडियम और सम अदर मेटल आल्सो, बट सिंपल iron nanoparticles, they are just, if it is dug and put into it, so the water flows through this and gets purified. So this is how biotechnological processes in nanotechnology, that is another field coming up. Nano, you know, every material at nano size. What is nano size? You know, the millimeter is 1/1000th of a meter. Micrometer is 1/1000th of a millimeter. Then nano is 10^-9 thousandth of a micrometer. So at that level, you know, all properties change. The next 42. The next big thing is really small. The nanotechnology is coming in a big way now, because all properties, they change at that level. Next one, 43. Now I want to say that how computer science and life sciences, they are, how computer is helping in to solve the life processes, problems. You know, it has been reported by a professor at University of California that 1 gram of, just imagine, 1 gram of DNA can store as much information as a trillion compact disks. So biology has really good potential. Another professor at Harvard, he says that we are harvesting new ways of harvesting massive data. Now massive data is coming from every field. How to analyze that? So we have to take help of IT. Information technology will help in solving all these problems. Next one, 44. Now, computer science has provided very highly useful data, and you know, modeling, mathematical modeling is helping like anything. Simulation processes occurring in living cells, they are simulated on computers. Then algorithms are being framed to solve science problems. So computer science now is coming in a big way to solve all these biotechnological problems. Next one, 45. I just wanted to tell you that now programming language is coming for living cells. Now synthetic biology techniques, they become powerful, and in future they are expecting, like electronic circuits, you know, you must have seen how electronic circuits work. So biological circuits will be similar to the design of integrated circuits in electronics. Nielsen, he's a famous name, he describes what is essentially a programming language to design computational circuits in living cells. देखिए, लिविंग सेल में जो भी प्रोसेस हो रहा है उसको आप, ये हो रहा है ना कि लैब ऑन ए चिप, एक छोटे से चिप पर जो कि 1 cm² का होगा, आप यू कैन फ्रेम द होल टिश्यू ऑन दैट, यू कैन फ्रेम द होल ऑर्गन ऑन दैट. जस्ट इमेजिन, आई मीन हाउ चैलेंजिंग दिस वर्ल्ड, हाउ फैसिनेटिंग इट इज बिकमिंग. एक छोटे विच यू कैन कैरी इन योर हैंड एंड डू एनी टेस्ट एनी वेयर. Not only in the lab, you can go to any place of accident, you can go where interior mein jaake aap kuch bhi kariye. So thank you for listening.
Krishna ji, there are some questions, so but we don't have too much time left. I mean, we are almost at, it's 12 o'clock, but firstly I'll take the question which has come from a student. So this is the last question. She has asked, Shivangi Dastidhar has asked, that genes from bacteria have been used to make crop resistant to diseases. Can something similar be done for humans and bacteriophages to combat?
Sound nahi aa rahi hai, Anshumala. I am not able to hear properly.
Then maybe this is the last question in the chat box. Can you see the chat box?
Okay, just 1 minute.
Shall I repeat the question? If you can hear now. So Krishnaji, Vikas has put this on in the next another slide.
Please repeat
the slide. He has put the question, so maybe you can see it now.
Yeah, please. Yeah, can you tell me now?
The question is, genes from bacteria have been used to make crops resistant to disease. Can something similar be done for humans? And bacteriophages, she means that bacteriophages used to combat antimicrobial resistance. How viable is this?
Yeah, that is true. That is what I have tried to say. As you say that genes, they have improved, they have been put into plants to improve the quality. The same thing is genomic editing now. The genes can also be put in human beings to cure diseases for different things, So gene manipulation can be done in any living system. Bacteriophages, they are viruses attacking bacteria. So bacteria are also developing processes to combat this. This is what for the Nobel Prize has been given now. Am I clear?
That answers Shivangi's question. There's one interesting question from Raghu. He says, he's very disturbed. He's saying, but aren't there ethical issues in such research when you talk about gene manipulation or genetic engineering? So he says, aren't there ethical issues? Who gives consent for such research? And is there some regulatory system in place?
Yeah, this is a very good question because there are many ethical issues. I tell you that earlier when these clones were formed, one scientist, I am not able to recall the name of the scientist, but he said that he can make human clones. Human clone means for what purpose? Because if anybody's child has some disease, some organ has to be transplanted, he said that by taking a living cell from that child, he can create a clone from where the organ can be taken. But that was an ethical issue because, making a identical human being, what will happen to society? Because that scientist said that he was not permitted to do so. He said that he will go to some island where this rule doesn't apply and he will make clones of human being. But the thing is that this is unethical because what will happen to society? Suppose then, now because of this gene editing, genome editing, another thing has come. That people are saying that why can't we have designed babies? Designed babies means that parents can go and ask for, because whatever genome editing is known so far is only limited to somatic cells, not to the reproductive cells, not to ova and sperm. So if it is done in those cells, then by genome editing, certain desired qualities can be put in a baby and that baby will have that specific quality. So this you can have designer babies, but then this is a big ethical issue, And there are certain, ethical this thing permissions. There are committees in every country, but I think mostly ethical issues in medical this thing are solved at WHO level.
Some more questions are arising from your answers. So, one question is like you just said, it's like unethical to produce designer babies, but we are producing designer organisms, other organisms, like you said, particularly plants. So, I mean, if, like BT, cotton brinjal, there's been a whole debate around it. So that question still is pending. And then we have at least a couple of more questions. I mean, one question I had myself, I myself have about the process. I mean, when you, let's say, insert gene from elsewhere, from, let's say, a bacteria into a human or any other animal or plant. So that editing is done in one cell, right?
Yeah.
But then how will it affect the whole organism?
Yeah, because, you know, that one cell, that when it undergoes replication, that gene is carried through to the daughter cell.
So that's what my question was. So only those limited number of cells will have the edited version, no? So it, does that still work?
No, actually, all cells are differentiated. I mean, I think you are talking about stem cells. Stem cells in every organ are different.
I'm not talking about stem cells, but I'm not clear if genetic engineering is done only on stem cells or even ordinary other cells as well.
No, it is what exactly has to be cured, you know, because if the purpose is to sort of cure cancer, suppose, so you are taking the you are doing genetic editing in only the affected cells, which are undergoing mutation and then proliferation. No? So only those cells will be affected, not the normal cells.
Okay. Right. So Shivangi asked again, why can't gametes be genetically engineered? So I think Professor Krishna said that it's not ethical. It's ethically not allowed. It's, scientifically allowed, but not ethically. Zainab Mala has asked, is dermatoglyphix multiple intelligence test also related to genetic study? I don't understand this question, but yeah, you can respond to it.
Intelligence.
She said, is dermatoglyphix multiple intelligence test also related to genetic study? I don't understand the question.
Well, I think if you are talking about anything connected with brain, that is intelligence or whatever, I think most of the mechanisms, how brain works, you know, how exactly the intelligence, the natural intelligence is there, researches are going on, but still many things are not clear about the working of brain. So I'm not sure exactly what is the problem you are concerned with.
So we do have a couple of questions. I hope you have time.
Yeah, I have time. No problem.
And I don't know if amongst the audience, if people want to leave, they are most welcome. So because now we have finished the formal time, but informally we can carry on if some people want to be here and particularly if children want to ask more.
Sure.
So from one teacher, Deepika Maurya, a question has come. How eating modified rice transmits the gene for curing the disease? She's asking how it happens.
Yeah, that's a good question. And how it helped. The thing is, because as you know the vaccination, how vaccination mechanism is there, because what you do is you put an antigen into the body through injecting. Antigen means that the same disease, suppose you are vaccinating for a particular disease, smallpox le lijiye, smallpox ka vaccination pehle bana tha, to kya karte the, usi ko smallpox ke hi infected cells le karke usko attenuate karte. Attenuation means they treat it in a way that the activity becomes less. Kam active ho gaya, wo inject karte hain body mein, then the immunity, immune system works and it it produces antibodies. Dusra molecule banata hai, which can neutralize this these pathogens. So antibody banata hai, wo protein hai, theek hai? Wo antibody banaya whenever the same this thing virus or bacteria or whatever it is, jo pathogen attack karega. तो वो एंटीबॉडी आकर के उसको न्यूट्रलाइज करेगा. दैट्स हाउ इम्यूनिटी फंक्शंस. इन्होंने क्या किया कि ये जो रोटा वायरस था जिसकी वजह से डायरिया हो रहा था, उसका जो एंटीबॉडी बनाया और वो एंटीबॉडी वो प्रोटीन उस राइस में डाल दिया. अब क्या है, उस राइस को जो भी खाएगा वो एंटीबॉडी ऑलरेडी उसको उसके सिस्टम में चला गया. So that is present in this thing. जब उसको कोई भी ये डिजीज का अटैक करेगा तो वो एंटीबॉडी उसको न्यूट्रलाइज कर देगा. It is as simple. That's a simpler method of instead of vaccination, they put it in the food product में डाल देते हैं.
But I have my own question in response to your answer, which is like if you eat a protein, then it's broken down into its constituent amino acids. So then the protein will not remain as such in your blood, no?
Yeah, you are right. Through food. Yeah, that's a good question. How it goes into the bloodstream? That I have also to see this.
Sure. So we'll carry on conversation about this later. There's another question. Gene editing be helpful in curing any brain disease?
Yeah, sure. Sure. Any disease can be cured. No problem, because that particular gene only has to be modified, replaced, or whatever has to be done. So that can be done for brain diseases also. No problem.
Okay. So another question here from Preeti is, why BT toxin does not affect the human body? Carries on saying human gut has an alkaline pH. She's asking.
BT toxin, actually it is easier saying that you can put any gene from anything into anything, but there comes the question of compatibility. हर चीज में नहीं होता. वो लोग कोशिश करते हैं वेक्टर्स के साथ डालने की जीन को, लेकिन एवरीथिंग एवरी जीन कैन नॉट बी ट्रांसफर टू एवरी सिस्टम. नेचर कभी कभी उसको नहीं फॉलो करता, नहीं देखता. सो बीटी जीन हैज नेवर बीन पुट इन ह्यूमन बीइंग. नो
No, she's saying this. Suppose you generate BT brinjal or BT tomato, so that toxin, doesn't that toxin affect us humans?
No, it doesn't affect.
Okay. Then Neha Pardeshi has asked, for coronavirus, sweet lime or any vitamin C material, will it be? Is it very good? She's asking, and what is the connection between any vitamin C and resistance or let's say immunity to coronavirus? That's probably the question.
Oh, for coronavirus, actually, since they don't have any potent drug so far, so what they are saying that you increase your immunity. So that is the only alternative, that enhance your immunity, and vitamin C helps in enhancing the immunity. That's all. It is no cure.
Okay. So now, unless the audience have more questions, some questions have come which are actually which require a textbook answer. For example, somebody has asked. Rashna Yadav has asked that, can you explain a bit more about genes and what is the difference between chromosomes, genes, and DNA? I would request Rashna to go and see the answer in a textbook, because
yeah, this is given in textbook.
Yeah, this is a very routine question. Ma'am, you'll have to make your camera a little above. I mean, we couldn't see your full face again. So if there are no questions and no more questions, we will then stop here. Unless, I mean, I'll just wait for a minute to see if audience has anything else to ask. And you are all welcome to send more questions to us on the WhatsApp group. We will pass them on to ma'am and take answers from her. She's very happy to interact with children and teachers. Shashwati Ghosh has asked, can you suggest a good book on biotech?
What is the question?
Can you suggest a good book on biotech?
On biotech?
Yes.
Oh, biotech has many books, several books. And if you are specifically interested in gene, there are different volumes on only genes. No? I think the 12th volume has come now. But as such, you know, there are many Indian books also now on biotechnology. Maybe I'm not able to remember. I'm not remembering the names of authors at present.
Rachna Yadav has asked, if genes can be used to treat many diseases, then why do we still have so much of sickness around?
Why we have so much of?
Sickness. I mean, so much illness still.
Sickness?
Yes.
Yeah, because this technology has now come. No, it will be available in future.
Yeah, so it offers hope for the future. Actually, that was what ma'am was trying to say throughout the lecture, that there's so much hope and there are so many possibilities as long as we can use it well. So anyway, you have feedback, ma'am. Neha Pardeshi is saying she wants to say that the information given by you was very important for us. Thank you so much for your valuable words and speech. So I would also like to say the same. It has been a pleasure, Krishnaji, to have you here and with your vast experience and knowledge to talk to children and teachers. So I hope the relationship will continue. For the audience, we'll be happy to bring scientists to you twice in a month. So this series will continue in the name of Let's Talk Science. And we'll keep bringing it to you. Vikas will just post the our general announcement group where we keep announcing our future events. They are also announced on Facebook. Even this talk will be stored on Facebook for anybody else who wants to hear later. So, all sessions these days are stored on our Facebook page. So these as well as our regular webinars, which are on specific topics. So people who are asking about what is a gene or what is a chromosome, what is DNA helical structure, you are requested to attend our regular session, which deals with the curriculum. So we take curriculum knowledge there, and a lot many more people are thanking you, ma'am, Krishnaji. So it's been such a pleasure to have you here, and the talk was very informative, very very interesting. I wish I could actually poke you more like as a child. Hopefully I'll do it personally. So thank you, ma'am, for coming here, and thanks to the audience for being there for this wonderful talk. So with that,
thank you for this interactive session. I am also put to some questions myself, and I'll clarify those. And maybe that I'll explain to Anshumala.
great to hear. I'll poke you with more questions. So thanks and goodbye, everyone. See you in future. So we are finishing the meeting.